Assalamu alaikum students, today we'll discuss one of the most important and frequently used punctuation mark, and that is comma. We'll see uses and examples of this important punctuation mark. So let's see. Do any of the following sentences look or sound odd when you read them aloud? Let's take a picture of koala's trees and mountains. I want to eat grandma. She left the States on May 21st, 1999. गौर से सुनिए, क्या आपको इसमें कोई प्रॉब्लम नजर आ रहा है? अगर है तो आगे चल के देखते हैं कि ये प्रॉब्लम हम कैसे फिक्स कर सकते हैं. कॉमा. द कॉमा इज अ पंक्चुएशन मार्क दैट इंडिकेट्स अ सॉफ्ट स्टॉप और पॉज बिटवीन द पार्ट्स इन अ सेंटेंस. In grammar, a comma can be used to separate the items in a list, parts of a date, or words that need direct attention. In this lesson, we'll focus on 12 basic comma rules. So let's see all these rules with examples. First use, separating elements in a series. It means that comma is used to separate the elements in a series. जब किसी भी लिस्ट में एलिमेंट्स हम देते हैं तो अगर हम उनको कॉमास के जरिए सेपरेट ना करें तो वो मिक्सअप हो जाएंगे एंड दे वुड कंफ्यूज द रीडर. तो उस कंफ्यूजन से बचने के लिए हम क्या करेंगे? वी विल सेपरेट द एलिमेंट्स आइटम्स इन द लिस्ट. सो लेट्स सी. दे वांट टू बाय आइसक्रीम टॉपिंग्स एंड केक. Do you find there is some problem here in this list? Yes, there is a problem. And we'll fix the problem by adding comma. And now you can see that all the items are separated through comma and they are quite easily understandable. There is no confusion at all, right? Fine. Commas not only separate the elements in a series, but also it separates phrases in a series, in a list. Like, the zoo had roaring lions, playing bears and zebras. Now here you can see that we have participle phrases, roaring lions and then playing bears. We are confused whether the lions are playing or the bears are playing. So ye confusion kaise khatam ki ja sakti hai? That is too simple. What we will do? We'll just add commas. By adding commas, now we have no confusion in these phrases, right? We are absolutely clear that these are the bears who are playing and the lions are roaring. So this is how we clear the confusion through commas in a series. It doesn't matter whether in a series there are just one word elements or there are phrases. Commas would help you everywhere. Right? Okay, let's look at this example. She hit the ball, ran to first base, scored 1 point and did a happy dance. So this statement was actually confusing for me as well. जब मैं इसको read करने लगी तो मुझे बहुत सारी confusion हुई कि अच्छा कौन सा part जो है उस पर मैंने pause करना है, कौन सी phrase किसके साथ join है. तो आपके reader के साथ भी यही होता है, जब आप commas add नहीं करते तो reader get confused. रीडर को समझ में नहीं आती कि कौन सा जो कंपोनेंट है वो किसके साथ अटैच है. तो अभी हम देखें कि जब हम कॉमाज ऐड कर देंगे तो क्या होता है. लेट्स सी. नाउ इट्स ब्यूटीफुल एंड इट्स सिंपल. आप इसको बहुत इजीली अंडरस्टैंड कर सकते हैं. और हमें क्या पता चला कि शी हिट द बॉल कॉमा रैन टू फर्स्ट बेस कॉमा स्कोर्ड 1 point कॉमा एंड डिड अ हैप्पी डांस. सो इट वॉज ईजी फॉर मी टू रीड नाउ, राइट? तो वी हैव टू मेक द जॉब ऑफ आवर रीडर ईजी. एंड हाउ कैन इट बी डन? सो बाई एडिंग कॉमाज एट देयर प्रॉपर प्लेसेज टू सेपरेट द फ्रेजेज, राइट? तो अब हमें पता चल गया कि वर्ब फ्रेजेज हैं ये सारी और इनको अंडरस्टैंड करना हमारे लिए कोई मुश्किल नहीं है. लेट्स मूव. ओके, ऑक्सफोर्ड कॉमा. Are you aware about this concept of Oxford comma? If you are not aware, so let's see. It's important that we also take note of a common term you may hear, the Oxford comma. The Oxford comma is the final comma in a series. For example, use the comma to separate list of item. Like here you can see x, comma y, comma and z, or x, comma y and z. So you can see here that we added comma before coordinating conjunction and, right? This comma is called Oxford comma. And here you can see that we didn't add comma before the final conjunction. Choice is yours. अगर आप ये comma add करते हैं तो be consistent. जब भी आप अपनी राइटिंग में फिर आप ये वाला कॉमा ऑक्सफोर्ड कॉमा ऐड करें तो आप कंसिस्टेंटली इसको सारी राइटिंग में यूज़ करें. इफ़ यू डोंट वांट टू यूज़ कॉमा इट्स ओके, इवन देन यू आर राइट, फाइन. लेकिन फिर आपने कंसिस्टेंटली इसी पैटर्न को फॉलो करना होगा, राइट. लेट्स मूव. ओके, हियर वी हैव वन एग्जाम्पल विद without Oxford comma and one example with Oxford comma. So let's see. Social media include Facebook, comma, Twitter, comma, WhatsApp, comma, LinkedIn, comma, Instagram and YouTube. You can see here that before the final conjunction we didn't add any comma. This is perfectly fine. Aapki choice hai. Let's move. Social media include Facebook, comma, Twitter, comma, WhatsApp, comma, LinkedIn, in comma, Instagram, and now here you can see this is the Oxford comma and YouTube. So it's up to you whether you want to add this comma or not, but whatever pattern you follow, be consistent in that. Let's move. Note, if the list includes a compound, make sure not to separate these items with the comma. Agar koi compound word hai जिसमें दो वर्ड मिलते हैं और उनके दरमियान हो सकता है कि कंजंक्शन भी हो, इन दैट केस आपने कॉमा यूज़ नहीं करना. अभी मैं आपको एक एग्जांपल के ज़रिए शो करती हूँ. मेक श्योर टू आल्सो हैव द एक्स्ट्रा कंजंक्शन ऑन द फाइनल आइटम इवन इफ अ कंपाउंड. अभी इसको देखते हैं एग्जांपल को. सी हियर, मोस्ट मल्टीनेशनल कंपनीज हैव डिफरेंट डिपार्टमेंट्स कॉमा सच एज ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज कॉमा फाइनेंस and research and development working together to achieve the company's goal. So here you can see that research and development, this is a compound, right? So and it is separated through and. आप देख सकते हैं and. इसलिए यहाँ पे हमने comma add नहीं करना. एक तो ये बात है, जब ये एक ही word की sense दे रहा है तो आपने यहाँ पे comma add नहीं करना, one thing. Second, there is a confusion in this sentence. Is this finance and research or is this research and development? Compound kya hai? That is the confusion. To is confusion ko clear karne ke liye Oxford comma is ideal. ठीक है, Oxford comma हमें कैसे help out करेगा? जब आप finance के बाद comma add कर देंगे तो आपके reader को बिल्कुल भी confusion नहीं होगी कि finance जो है that is a separate word and research and development is compound. ठीक है, आप जब comma add कर देंगे तो इससे ये confusion ख़त्म हो जाएगी. But still, अगर आप यहाँ पे Oxford comma use नहीं करना चाहते तो आपके पास एक second option भी है. Let's see what is that second option. आप क्या कर सकते हैं कि आप compound को start में ले आएं. Most multinational companies have different departments such as research and development, comma, human resources and finance working together to achieve the company's goal. So here you can see that we didn't add any Oxford comma. What we did, we just brought this compound in the start, right? So after this we don't need to add Oxford comma here if we don't want to do it. Agar isko add kar de to tab bhi problem koi nahi hai, right? Let's move. Now we'll move towards the second use. And the second use is separating adjectives from each other. अगर आप दो adjectives use कर रहे हैं या दो से ज़्यादा adjectives use कर रहे हैं, आप कोई conjunction नहीं add करना चाहते, in that case, what you do, you separate the adjectives through comma. Look at this example. Tyrone had a strong, comma, legendary appetite. Or Tyrone had a strong legendary appetite. Which one is correct? Of course, this one. Why? Because now both the adjectives are separated through comma. Right? most of the time students have confusion. Where should we add comma? Is it necessary to add comma between all the adjectives? या कुछ ऐसी situations भी हैं, कुछ ऐसी conditions भी हैं जहाँ पे हमें adjectives को commas के जरिए separate नहीं करना. तो इसके लिए एक simple सा rule है, वो याद रखें that if you can put and between the adjectives that describes the noun. अगर तो आप adjectives के दरमियान and लगाएं और आपको लगे कि ये and proper है, in that situation what you should do, you should add comma instead of and. फिर तो आप and की जगह comma use कर सकते हैं. Otherwise अगर आपको लगता है कि and को add करने से जो आपके adjectives हैं वो awkward लग रहे हैं, तो इसका मतलब है कि आप comma भी add नहीं कर सकते. For example, Matilda loves organic chicken eggs. Do you think we should add comma here between organic and chicken? अगर and लगाएंगे तो कैसा लगेगा? Matilda loves organic and chicken eggs. It's looking too awkward. It means कि यहाँ पे and भी नहीं लगा सकते, और अगर and नहीं लगा सकते तो it means comma भी नहीं लगा सकते, right? तो आपने बस ये देखना है कि adjectives के दरमियान and लगाने से अगर वो proper लग रहे हैं, they are giving the sense, तो ठीक है, इसका मतलब है कि comma की space भी मौजूद है. आप कॉमा एंड की जगह या लगा सकते हैं. अदरवाइज एंड अगर इम्प्रॉपर है, ऑकवर्ड लग रहा है, वियर्ड है, तो इन दैट सेंस आप कॉमा वहां पे ना लगाएं, आप उन एडजेक्टिव्स को सेपरेट मत करें. आई होप इट्स क्लियर. लेट्स मूव. थर्ड यूज, सेपरेटिंग इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉजेस. यूज अ कॉमा बिटवीन इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉजेस दैट आर लिंक्ड बाय अ कोऑर्डिनेटिंग कंजंक्शन. आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल अवेयर that independent clauses are joined together through coordinating conjunction. The famous fanboys, you are well aware. So whenever you use coordinating conjunctions to join the two independent clauses, what you do, you add comma before the coordinating conjunction. Let's see some of the examples. You can see here, human beings have always prided themselves on their unique capacity to create and manipulate symbols, comma, but today computers are manipulating symbols, right? So here you can see that we have two independent clauses. This is the first independent clause. This one, today computers are manipulating symbols, this is the second independent clause. And both these independent clauses are joined together through coordinating conjunction, but. And what we did here, we added comma before the coordinating conjunction, right? So that is also the rule, remember it. Okay, now we'll move towards the fourth use, separating independent and dependent clauses. So the rule is that whenever the dependent clause is in the start, you always separate it through comma. For example, if they want to win, comma, athletes must exercise every day. So here you can see that we have dependent clause in the start and then we have independent clause. So whenever the dependent clause is in the start, we always separate it through comma. I hope it's clear. Now let's move towards the next sentence. We threw the ball for Smokey because he kept barking insistently. So here you can see that independent clause is in the start and dependent clause comes afterward. अगर इस तरह की सिचुएशन हो जिसमें डिपेंडेंट क्लॉज बाद में आए, तो फिर हमने कॉमा से उनको सेपरेट नहीं करना, राइट? कॉमा हम सिर्फ उसी वक्त लगाएंगे, उसी वक्त डिपेंडेंट क्लॉज को सेपरेट करेंगे जब डिपेंडेंट क्लॉज स्टार्ट में हो, राइट? सो डोंट फॉरगेट दिस रूल. लेट्स मूव. फिफ्थ यूज, सेपरेटिंग इंट्रोडक्टरी वर्ड्स. Sometimes we use introductory words like meanwhile, still, however. तो जब भी हम ये introductory words use करते हैं, remember always separate them from the main sentence through comma. As you can see here, meanwhile, comma, the athletes trained on the Nautilus equipment, right? Still, comma, the credibility of some witnesses was in question. I hope it's clear. Let's move. Separating introductory words again, words that are not part of the sentence. Sometimes we use certain adverbs like unfortunately, frankly, hopefully, sadly. They are not part of the sentence, rather they are on opinion. So that type of words are also separated through comma from the main sentence. Luckily, comma, he escaped the accident, full stop. Frankly, comma, I don't care whether people appreciate me or not. So here you can see that all these words have been separated through comma. I hope it's clear. Let's move. Forms of address. Whenever you use such form of address like Ali, Sir, Madam, you always separate them through comma. For example, Ali, comma, will you come with me? Sir, comma, will you join me in the meeting? Madam, comma, will you help me? You is skipped here. It's a typo mistake. Sorry for that. Let's move. 6U, separating introductory phrases. That is the most frequent mistake in writing, which I observe, that whenever the phrases are used in the start or sometimes in the middle, they are not separated by the students, right? So that's a mistake. Whenever they are used in the start, for example, here you can see, to stay in shape for competition, comma, athletes must exercise every day. So in this sentence, you can see, this is the infinitive phrase and this one is main clause, right? So infinitive phrase has been separated through comma, right? And that is the rule which you are supposed to follow. Let's move towards the next sentence. Here, barking insistently, comma, Smokey got us to throw his ball for run. So you can see here that this is the participle phrase and we separated it from rest of the sentence from the main clause through comma. Let's move. Okay, next is an appositive phrase. A popular and well-respected mayor, comma, Belly was the clear favorite in the campaign for governor. So here you can see that this phrase, this is appositive and it is a kind of modifier for belly, right? It is modifying this noun and we are separating it through comma. Let's move. After the adjustment for inflation, comma, real wages have decreased while corporate profits have grown. So here you can see that this is the prepositional phrase and we separated it from the main clause through comma. I hope it's clear. Let's move. Seventh use, separating non-essential elements that are not important. Actually, it's very important for us as a writer to show which information is important and which information is not essential, it's not important. जब हम बात कर रहे होते हैं तो उस वक्त हमारे पास टोन होती है. टोन के जरिए हम किसी भी इंफॉर्मेशन को एम्फसाइज कर देते हैं सिर्फ ये शो करने के लिए कि ये इंफॉर्मेशन इंपॉर्टेंट है. लेकिन जब हम राइटिंग कर रहे हैं तो दैट टोन इज मिसिंग. ये टोन हमारे पास नहीं होती. तो हाउ कैन वी कंपनसेट दिस इशू? दिस कैन बी कंपनसेटेड थ्रू कॉमास. कॉमास से जब भी हम कोई एलिमेंट्स सेंटेंस के सेपरेट कर देंगे, इट मीन्स कि दैट इज अ नॉन एसेंशियल एलिमेंट, दैट इज unimportant information. For example, here are some clues to help you decide whether the sentence element is essential. If you leave out the clause, phrase or word, does the sentence still make sense? अगर आप किसी भी clause को, phrase को या word को omit कर देते हैं, तो क्या आपका sentence still sense दे रहा है? अगर still वो complete meaning दे रहा है, तो it means कि that clause, phrase or word is not that much important and that can be separated through comma. Number two, does the clause, phrase or word interrupt the flow of words in the original sentence? Does that clause, phrase or word ये interrupt कर रहा है flow of words को original sentence में, right? अगर ये effect नहीं कर रहा आपकी फ्लुएंसी को, तो इट मींस कि इसको बहुत इजीली आप कॉमर्स के जरिए ओमेट कर सकते हैं, इसको सेपरेट कर सकते हैं. इफ़ यू मूव द एलिमेंट टू अ डिफरेंट पोजीशन इन द सेंटेंस, डज द सेंटेंस स्टिल मेक सेंस? उस फ्रेज को, उस क्लॉज को, उस वर्ड को आप डिफरेंट पोजीशंस पे रख के देखें, अगर डिफरेंट पोजीशंस पे जाने से वो ओवरऑल मीनिंग पे अफेक्ट नहीं कर रहा, ओवरऑल मीनिंग सेम रहते हैं, इट मींस के दैट क्लॉज, दैट फ्रेज और दैट वर्ड इज नॉट दैट मच इम्पॉर्टेंट। तो ये थोड़ा सा क्राइटेरिया अंडरस्टैंड करने के लिए। बाकी ये है कि आपने खुद भी देखना है कि वो इन्फॉर्मेशन कितनी इम्पॉर्टेंट है आपके लिए। अगर आप समझते हैं कि ये इन्फॉर्मेशन इतनी इम्पॉर्टेंट नहीं है, जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन आपने दे दी है, तो फिर आप उसको सेपरेट कर दें थ्रू कॉमास टू एम्फसाइज दैट दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन इज नॉन एसेंशियल। अगर आपको फील होता है कि वो इन्फॉर्मेशन इम्पॉर्टेंट है, तो फिर उसको कॉमास के जरिए सेपरेट मत करें। अभी मैं आपको एग्जाम्पल्स के जरिए समझाती हूँ। ओके, हियर यू कैन सी सम ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ नॉन एसेंशियल एलिमेंट्स, एंड फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल विल सी ऑफ क्लॉजेस दैट ट्यूजडे कॉमा विच हैपन्स टू बी माई बर्थ डे कॉमा इज द ओनली डे वेन आई एम अवेलेबल टू मीट। सो हियर यू कैन सी वी हैव वन डिपेंडेंट क्लॉज एंड दिस इज नॉन एसेंशियल विच हैपन्स टू बी माई बर्थ डे एंड इट इज डिफाइनिंग दिस ट्यूजडे। एक्चुअली द एक्चुअल सेंटेंस इज दैट That Tuesday is the only day when I'm available to meet. So, ये एक extra information दे दी गई है, right? But because it is not that much important, so that's why it has been separated through comma. Next example, people loves to celebrate New Year's Eve, comma, which is the last of the year. So here you can see that which is the last of the year, this is dependent clause. And this is unimportant information as well. The main information lies here. People love to celebrate New Year's Eve, right? And everyone is aware that New Year Eve is the last of the year. So this is just unimportant information. It is there, and because it's not that much important, so it has been separated through comma. Ek aur cheez aap observe kare. कि जब नॉन एसेंशियल क्लॉज जो है वो मिडल ऑफ द सेंटेंस में होती है तो वी सेपरेटेड थ्रू टू कॉमास, बट वंस इट इज इन द एंड वी सेपरेटेड ओनली थ्रू वन कॉमा, और इफ इट इज इन द स्टार्ट इवन देन हम एक कॉमा लगाते हैं। सो यू नीड टू रिमेंबर दैट। नेक्स्ट फ्रेज, दिस रेस्टोरेंट हैज एन एक्साइटिंग एटमोस्फियर, the food on the other hand is rather bland. So here you can see that there is a non-essential phrase on the other hand, right? And we will use two commas again. Here you can see this is one comma. मैंने पिक्चर थोड़ी सी नीचे की है ताकि आपको नजर आए। दिस इज वन कॉमा एंड दिस इज अनदर कॉमा, राइट? तो इन दो कॉमास के जरिए आपने इस नॉन एसेंशियल फ्रेज ऑन द अदर हैंड को सेपरेट किया, राइट? लेट्स मूव। ओके, नेक्स्ट वर्ड, आई अप्रिशिएट योर हार्ड वर्क, फुल स्टॉप। इन दिस केस हाउएवर यू सीम टू हैव ओवर एग्जर्टेड योर सेल्फ। नाउ हाउएवर दिस वन इज एन अनइम्पॉर्टेंट वर्ड हियर, एंड अगेन बिकॉज इट इज इन द मिडल सो वी सेपरेटेड इट थ्रू टू कॉमास। आई होप इट्स क्लियर, लेट्स मूव। Don't separate essential elements with commas. Yes, you need to remember. If there is any important information, if there is any essential information, then you would not separate it through comma. For example, students who cheat only harm themselves. So here you can see who cheat, right? This is the dependent clause and it is modifying students. We are not talking about all the students. Only those students who cheat. Right? So, because the information is important, we didn't separate it through comma. Next, the baby wearing a yellow jumpsuit is my niece. Now, here you can see, this is the participle phrase, wearing a yellow jumpsuit. And this is an important information because it is specifying the baby. Which baby? The one who is wearing a yellow jumpsuit. Right? Let's move. The candidate who had the least money lost the election. So, who had the least money? This is dependent clause here. And it is modifier for the candidate. As it is important information and we want to tell the reader that this is important information. That's why we are not separating it through comma. Right? Let's move. That clauses after nouns are always essential. This is the rule that clauses after nouns are always essential and they are not separated through comma. Similarly, that clauses following a verb expressing mental actions are also essential. Or those verbs, the stative verbs which show the mental condition, the mental action with that clause, they are important and they are not separated through comma. Let's see some of the examples. The book that I borrowed from you is excellent. So here you can see that I borrowed from you. This is that clause, and we never separate that clause from the main clause because it is always important, right? The apples that fell out of the basket are bruised. Again, that clause is not separated through comma. Next example, that clause is following a verb expressing mental action. Right, so mental action जो हमारी clauses show कर रही होती हैं with that, they are also not separated through comma. For example, she believes that she will be able to earn an A. Right, let's move. Eighth use, use commas to separate contrasting parts. वो parts जो एक दूसरे के opposite हैं. For example, he was laughing at you, comma, not with you. So this is the contrasting information, right? And this is separated through comma. Next example, that is my money, comma, not yours. So again, the contrasting information has been separated through comma. Okay, to George Harrison had been a sort of idol. What is this? Yes, this is the ninth use, that whenever there is any confusion, you need to prevent it in order to avoid the misreading or in order to avoid the confusion. Do you find there is any confusion? Yes, we think that this is one word, maybe name of the one person, but actually it is not so. To George, comma, Harrison had been a sort of idol, right? So by adding comma, there is no more confusion. We got to know, okay, what are the real meanings of this sentence. Let's move. Ninth use, use commas whenever necessary to prevent possible confusion or misreading. Like, I want to eat grandma. I want to eat grandma, for God's sake. What should we say? I want to eat, comma, grandma. Now it is clear that the person is saying to grandma that I want to eat. The person is not saying that I want to eat grandma, right? So that is the misunderstanding. Let's move. Tenth use, use of commas in dates. Remember, whenever you use month, date and year, you always separate date from the year through comma. However, if you only use month and year, in that situation you don't separate them through comma, right? Let's move. After the greetings, in a friendly letter and in closing of all letters. Whenever you are using greetings in the friendly letter, you always add comma after the greetings. And as far as the closing are concerned, no matter whether it's a business letter or it's a friendly letter, we always add comma after closing, right? Let's move. 11th use, to shift between the main discourse and a quotation. I think that's very important and you are already aware of it. For example, John said, without emotion, comma, inverted commas begin. I'll see you tomorrow, right? So here you can see we separated the main discourse from quotation through comma, right? So if the quotation is written in this way, it is interrupted. So in that situation, you can see that we are adding comma inside the inverted commas, right? So that's just a bit of tussle between America and British. So the most frequent use is this one, that we add comma inside the inverted commas, right? Let's move. Where not to use commas. If it's important for you to understand where to use commas, this is also important to see where should we not use commas. If there are only two items in a list or a series, only two, then we'll not separate them through comma. For example, you will only be permitted to bring a pencil and notebook. Here you can only add the conjunction, right? So that is sufficient. Compounds like Ali and Ayub, here you don't need to add comma, right? If there had been more than two, then you could have opted for comma, right? Let's move. If any of the series of items contains its own comma, separate them with a semicolon, right? For example, the meeting will be chaired by Mr. Aliyawan, comma, who will lead the finance department, comma, Ms. Maria Hashmi, comma, our keynote speaker, here it is our, right? Keynote speaker and head of HR department, comma, and Mr. Mohammed Ayub, comma, the vice president of our company. My God, a lot of commas. And the series is just mixed up. We are not clear about the meanings, about the sense of this sentence. So how can the confusion be removed? We should remove some of the unnecessary commas. So what we can do, we can add semicolons, right? To separate one item of the series from the other. Like the meeting will be chaired by Mr. Aliyawan, comma, who will lead the finance department, semicolon. Ms. Maria Hashmi, comma, our keynote speaker and head of HR department, semicolon, and Mr. Mohammed Ayub, comma, and the vice president of our company. So now we are absolutely clear by adding semicolon, and the series is quite understandable for us, right? Let's move. Yes. So now I have brought an exercise for you. I have shared a lot of rules with you. So now this is the time to test your understanding. So let's move and see how much have you understood. Okay. My three favorite foods are pasta, pizza, and ice cream. Do you think there is any problem? You are right. We are supposed to separate the items in the series through comma, right? So which one is correct? First one or second one? Yes, second one is correct, right? Let's move. We can go to the grocery store or we can go to the mall. Is this sentence correct? Yes, you are right. This is incorrect. But how can it be corrected? You can see here that this one is independent clause. We can go to the grocery store or we can go to the mall. This one is also independent clause. So what we can do that we can add comma before the conjunction or, right? The way we do in compound sentences. So here you can see by adding comma, now this sentence is correct, right? When I get to the mall, I will go to the food court. Do you remember the rules? Yes, you are right. Whenever the dependent clause is in the start, we always separate it through comma. So here you can see. Okay, I hope it's understandable. Let's move. I like video games, but my sister, on the other hand, does not. So here you can see that the unnecessary component of information is there. And what is that? On the other hand. And we have separated it through comma. Right? Let's move. Gas is too expensive, said the experienced driver. So what we need to do here? Yes, we need to add the comma here to separate the main discourse from the quotation. Fine, let's move. Excuse me, you left your bag on the counter. So what we need to do here, whenever there are introductory words like this, we separate them through comma. Fine, let's move. Today is Tuesday, June 10th, 1992. So what can we do here? We can separate the date from the year, and that is the rule. Never forget it. Okay, for queries, comment below. Thank you so much for listening. See you in the next lecture with some other good topic. Until then, bye.